Hey there. It's been a while, hasn't it?
Yeah, it is.
All right. So, I asked last time if you were interested in hearing my voice, my lovely, lovely voice again. LOL. And one person did respond, and that's Sapphire K, and I always appreciate seeing you in my comments. Like, bruh, I really do appreciate you, so, I don't know. I'll do the rest of the crystal gems drawing soon. I just need a break from all the chibis, and I want to do some more, like, not normal, but some of my other kind of art. And this week, because I'm obsessed with musicals, we got some Beetlejuice. Yeah. I have not actually drawn anything Beetlejuice yet. This is the first Beetlejuice drawing that I have drawn, even, like, I remember watching, like, one or two episodes of the cartoon when I was little, and then I watched the movie once, and it was a good movie, but it's been a long time, so the music's really good, and admittedly, I have been on TikTok a lot lately. I thought I would never get into it, and then here we are, making all these cosplay videos. Also, if you want to check me out, link on the screen, and in my description, if you want to watch those, it's fine, don't watch them, I'm being dumb. Anyway, I had some trouble drawing Lydia and Beetlejuice, and even now it's like I like how it turned out, but I still wished I did something different. I like how this drawing turned out, like as a whole, this is a great drawing, but you know, it's one of those like looking at it, I'm like, hey, there's things I could have done. Materials, because I figure that might be a good thing to list out. I'll start listing those in the description because I figure that might be helpful for some people. Some people like to draw, like see traditional art and then are curious what people use. So here's what I use. I've got a Papermate pencil that I've used these kinds of pencils for several years since high school. So it's like 10 years now. God, I am old as hecky. These Papermate pencils are really good and I have like a bajillion other erasers. So, you know, they last forever if you take good enough care of them. And 0.5 lead, if people care. I don't mind 0.7. I just kind of use whatever's on top of my pencil bag. I use my Prismacolors. I've got a 0.05, or 0.005, 0.1, and then my 0.8 for all that stuff. 0.05, 0.0, yeah, whatever, 0.05 is going to be for the teeny stuff, 0.1 is for everything else, and then 0.8 if I really want some big, like, outlines and stuff to really be more bold. I didn't use it that much in this, it was mostly for just filling in stuff, and I also have a Daiso pen that I got pretty recently, and I want to try it out. It's a water-based pen, so it ate through the paper, and you'll see in that, like, it kind of warps the paper if you use a lot of water-based. Paper is a cardstock that I just got from Michael's. It's like 100 pages or so, and I cut that in half. And I got that as a pro tip from another artist that I will link up on the screen, hopefully. It like saves a lot of money, and like I can save my Bristol for like bigger projects and stuff like that. So I totally love the cardstock idea, and it works for my alcohol-based markers. My alcohol-based markers are a mix of Copics, Prismacolors, Artist Loft, Concept, and those are the only ones that I used in this video. I really like my Copics, so I use them whenever I have the chance, and then if I can, I avoid using them for backgrounds because it kills them. My Prismacolors are really good for like extra background space. And the Artist Loft are good for, you know, just little details and stuff because they can die pretty quickly. You pay for what you get. Then my Pipsqueaks, which are just Crayola Pipsqueaks. I got a pack of 64 like 4 years ago and they're still going strong. They're some of my favorite stuff to just have some fun with and play around with. Crayola is one of my favorite brands, like just to have for filling in stuff. So if you just are on a budget, it's totally worth them. One downside is they're water-based, so they, like I said with the Daiso, they'll warp the paper. And then lastly, I've got my Jelly Rolls and then my Zebra Sarasa white pen. The Jelly Rolls are really good for like the glittery stuff, and I like to use them as like little accents and stuff. You saw them in my SpongeBob one, and I use a little bit of it on Beetlejuice and a little bit on Lydia, which I really like, and for writing that beautiful sound. And yeah, I think that's everything. If you want to watch my dumb cosplay videos, so far I have done an OC several times. I have done Klaus Hargreaves because I love him, and SpongeBob because I'm hyperfixating. I have plans to do some more in the future, near future. It's just I do them like late at night, and it's a bit of work to get into the cosplay and doing the makeup and stuff like that. It's fun, but it's just a lot. So I just like mass record things. Anyway, I think that is everything. If you like how this is going, I can totally do this. I like talking. I'm a very chatty person. And if you ever have any questions, I'm totally in the comments. I try to respond within like the first 3 or 4 days. If I don't respond right away, I am so sorry. Sometimes I just like things because I'm like, I don't want to sound redundant, but I do really appreciate every comment, every like, every view, like every subscription, everything that everybody's like so nice on here. Like, wow, people are really nice. So, thank you for listening to me chatter. I'm just gonna end this with the music from the original Beetlejuice movie, because I think that's gonna be easier to find than instrumentals from the show. Thanks for listening to me, and I hope you enjoy the rest of this drawing. Okay, bye. Thank you.